Hey, it's Professor Dave. Let's learn about polynomials.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Now that we know the very basics of algebra and algebraic equations, it's time to tackle a particular type of equation that you will see countless times. These are called polynomials, and they are expressions that contain an unknown raised to various positive whole number exponents. This could be something like 2x squared plus 4x plus 10 equals 0. We can see that there is an x squared term, an x term, and a number, or constant, and that's what makes this a polynomial, because it follows the general form of a sub n x to the n plus a sub n minus 1 x to the n minus 1 plus a sub n minus 2 x to the n minus 2, and so on until we get to a1x plus a0, a constant. If there is just one term, like 2x, it's a monomial. If there are two terms, like 2x minus 1, it's a binomial. Three terms, like x squared plus 2x minus 1, would be a trinomial. Beyond this, there are no special names, so we can generally just call all of these polynomials, whether there is one term or 100. We definitely could have polynomials with many terms, going up to any integer exponent there could be, though we typically only interact with expressions that go up to a power of 3 or 4, maybe 5 or 6 once in a while. As we referenced, it is convention to list the terms in the polynomial by decreasing exponents. So we would say 3x cubed plus 5x squared minus 2x plus 7 equals 0 in that specific order, and typically not in some other order. Again, there is no firm reason for this, it's just convention. We should also note that the highest power present in the polynomial is called the degree of the polynomial. If the degree is 2, it is a second degree polynomial, also known as a quadratic polynomial. Third degree is known as cubic. Fourth degree is called quartic. Fifth degree is called quintic. And beyond that, we don't really have names. We would just say sixth degree, seventh degree, and so on. Also, polynomials don't have to have all the possible terms. 4x squared plus 7 is a polynomial even without a term for x raised to the first power. We can just think of it as 0x, which we simply omit. If we want to evaluate a polynomial for a specific value of x, it's pretty easy. We just have to plug in that value everywhere we find x. Using the previous expression, 2x squared plus 4x plus 10, if we want to evaluate this when x equals negative 1, we just plug it in. X squared will be 1, so we get 2 for the first term. 4x will end up as negative 4, and then the plus 10, so 2 minus 4 plus 10, which is 8. Now, solving polynomials, on the other hand, can be extremely complicated. Let's take the exact same expression we just looked at and set it equal to 0, as we typically do with polynomials. Now that we have an equation, we might want to solve for x, meaning we may want to find the values of x for which this expression would indeed equal 0. But we will quickly notice that all the strategies we have learned thus far will not work, because we have more than one x term, and they are not like terms that can be combined. We could subtract 10 from both sides, but then we are pretty much stuck. If we take a square root to try to lose the exponent, we get roots involved, so it would seem that we have no course available to solve for x. But don't worry, there are indeed a variety of ways to solve these kinds of equations, and we will learn them all, one by one. But it is worthwhile to note that when polynomials get much more complex than this, their solutions become so intricate that even brilliant mathematicians spend a lifetime trying to figure out ways to solve them. We won't be doing any of those, of course. We will just focus on the basics. But it is a good idea to show some reverence for the deep complexity that algebra is capable of. For now, just put that reverence in your pocket, as we've got a lot more work to do with polynomials. So let's move forward now. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.